You're getting way too big for your boots. Kick up the U. Man, know that I kick up the U. Them way there try to suck the truth. How dare you to suck the truth? Look, you're getting way too big for your boots. You're never too big for the boot. I got the big size toes on my feet. Your face ain't big for my boots. Kick up the U. Man, know that I kick up the U. Them boy there try to suck the truth. How dare you to suck the truth? Wanna come round here like a bad boy, do it. Run all the talking, go on and do it. Running through the party, bottle of balls on my ear, saying storms, don't do it. Devil on my shoulder, I don't lack. Getting with the business, I don't scrap. Even when I'm far, I'm so easy, right? But there's no car and no match.
What you talking about?
Clown, stand down. Never had a thing, never had a pound. You were never bad then, you ain't bad now. Never had them, had a then. Don't look back down. Wait, I saw bare kicks, saw bare clothes. Said not that, I can't wear those. I don't like them, they're not my thing. They went silent, they're all weirdos. Like, yeah, storms don't clear. Never had a Tom Ford or a Montclair. Man, them are calm, but you see my don there. Tell them don't do it, don't dare. Don't care who you know from my block. You're not Al Capone, they can take my car and my creps. I still do the road in my socks. Like, who's gonna stop me? You, him, little man. I got blue slims. Don't be an idiot, move smart. I've been killing it, new king. You were never ready for my new stuff. You're a boy by yourself, go and group up. And when crep went states for the BTs, I was covering crep like a boot cut. If mad, it's a family thing, straight family thing. Dumb man, I broke no salary thing. Had a dumb team called Amy telling me to come round hers on a Valerie thing. Hashtag Murky Academy thing, you were like art and the gallery thing. Dumb boy there, wanna chat about bars, wanna chat about, but you're getting way too big for your boots. You're never too big for the boot. I got the big size toes on my feet. Your face ain't big for my boots. Kick up the U. Man, know that I kick up the U. Them boy there, try to suck the truth. How dare you to suck the truth? Look, I'm too hot. I got money in my shoebox. I'm the man of the house when my show sold out like the brother from the Boondocks. Beat Swan in my boombox. Still meat from the stew pot. Man, I'm go sick on my tune drops. Little man, that's a who blow, not a who blow. What? Pronounce it right. I go magic, I'm down to die for this. I don't care, bro, I'm down. Man, stress, so I'm bound to lie. Wait, I'm bound to ride for flips. Real G's gonna ride around to this. Man, I got no time to write a diss. I never left my 9-to-5 for this waste, man, ting. I don't care what rave man's in. I came here to relax, but if it gets mad, make a young boy take man's things. Try to tell me I'm way too big to rebel. Nah, man, you're never too big to rebel. I was in the O2 singing my lungs out, rude, but you're never too big for Adele. Leave my yard, blow a kiss to my girl. Salute to my sister as well. Gotta keep trophies down at my mum's bit. Man, I'm getting way too big for my shelf. Man, I see bare MCs on the sideline, but I still got a couple bangs in the pipeline. Man, I got grown men at me. You're getting way too old for the timeline. You're getting way too old for this. Should've looked after your kids. Get out the booth, go home to your son. It's never too late to commit. It's like, man, love, put my name in a random flag, get a plane to Qatar. This year I learned how to take care of business. Next year I learned how to play the guitar. You're getting way too big for your boots. You're never too big for the boot. I got the big size toes on my feet. Your face ain't big for my boots. Kick up the U. Man, know that I kick up the U. Them boy there try to suck the truth. How dare you to suck the truth? Look, you're getting way too big for your boots. You're never too big for the boot. I got the big size toes on my feet. Your face ain't big for my boots. Kick up the U. Man, know that I kick up the U. Them boy there try to suck the truth. How dare you to suck the truth?
Charles and I set for this Madden Ultimate Team matchup as we get a peek some of the stars in today's game. Well, will they be stars? Will you be a star? We'll find out. Let's play. Ryan Succop, the man tasked with getting this one started. And we are underway in Foxborough. This is taken at the 3. And he'll have good starting field position as he's up just shy of the 40.
Kill.
Knock!
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Allen's got it over the middle. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. The completion good for three, and it's second down. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
That goes as a gain of 11 and a Patriot first down.
It's a nice completion, a little bit of run after catch as well to grade the yardage that they got. But it is so tough to cover that route, the drag route, because they run it at varying speeds. Because the key is to create hesitancy on the defender's part.
Always so empathetic for those DBs, aren't you? And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Looking to throw. That's caught by his tight end, Evan Ingram. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. Give him 15 yards on that one, and New England has a first down. And the offense lining up first and 10. Right side, Campbell, and a short gain down to about the 33. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again, go play action, hit them over the top.
On second down, Campbell. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. That'll be a New England first down, a gain of 12. That O-line, they cleared a big hole there on that run.
The athleticism of offensive lines continues to evolve, and we're seeing it here. Not only are they controlling things right the line of scrimmage, but they're able to get upfield to get to what we call the second and the third levels. You know, get to linebacker spot, the secondary spot. Getting all the way downfield with their blocking, which helps keep the running back clean.
They'll try to continue that trend here this afternoon. And he'll at least get them inside the red zone here, down to about the 19. Give them 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. Second down following the run. Switch it up here and look to throw. And they will not get the connection there. It's incomplete.
The effort's always going to be there. Everyone's always going to try and make a catch. But underthrown balls, I think, are the toughest ones to come back and get, because usually your momentum's going in the opposite direction when you're trying to stop, break, and come back and get it.
Third down, he'll drop to throw. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
This defense not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. He came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
And his kick is indeed good. And the Patriots jump out to a 3-0 lead. So the opening drive for them here on their home turf results in a field goal.
Now that's the way you want to get things started. Your stadium, your crowd, you've got the ball. Put points on the board first and let everyone start to celebrate.
Oh, nice move. And he will be taken down here as the first quarter of play will come to an end. The drive will start with a carry by Devontae Freeman. 25 yards the pick up there, and also a first down.
I love football lingo and the evolution of it all. Nickel defense makes sense, right? Five defensive backs. But then you go to six. What are you going to call that? And they call it a dime.
Double it.
A dime, which is just very simple for them. The math doesn't add up. But I know one thing. Offenses love to run against dime defenses. Typically, the bigger guys have an advantage against the smaller defensive backs when they're blocking downfield.
Yeah, we saw that advantage right there. Stafford on first down. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. The wise move there. Looked like nobody open. Now second down.
What's the old adage? Be quick, but don't hurry. Well, that went right out the window there. He was hurried, harassed. That ball had to be gotten rid of. Otherwise, he was going to get sacked.
So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. To throw again. Stafford. And a first hookup with his all-pro tight end, Rob Gronkowski. And a big hit at the end of that one. He's knocked down hard. On first down at Stafford. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Olivier Vernon. He's the one that got to him. He takes him down for a loss of 9. Here's Stafford now on second down. Completing it to the right side, Johnson. And he'll go down at the 28. A good pickup there, 13 yards as they get closer for third down. They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Throwing on third down, Stafford. Hard throw, incomplete. 58 to go in this first half of play. Back to Foxborough after this. So on fourth down, Marvin Lewis sends on the field goal unit from the right hand. This from 45 yards away. And this is right down the middle as he puts it through. And that will tie us at 3-3. So it's a 7-play drive, but it stalls out in the end.
Let's credit the defensive front 7. They were a little leaky at the start of the drive, but they stiffened toward the end.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. This is taken at the 3.
In a tie game, both sides are looking for something to give them an advantage. It often falls back on special teams. And that return, that could be the spark to untie the game.
And now out come the Patriots. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them wanted to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that. They weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick, other than the extra point. That's it.
A big play on the ground there. It goes for 36 yards.
All right, I've got to be careful here, all right? He's on the plus side of 30. There may be a little gray in the beard, but that's not slowing down his feet as far as he's concerned.
What are you saying? I'm on the plus side of 30.
Well, if you're on the plus side of 30, you don't know what I'm on the plus side of. All I know is that run right there, let us know there's still some life in those legs.
Absolutely, still got a lot of life left in those legs. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
And after that completion, you can understand why so many teams in the league are emphasizing speed on defense in every position. The tight ends have created so many tough matchups now. If you can't run with a tight end as a linebacker, this is going to be the result every time.
It's an 8-yard pickup, and it leads to a first and goal. And the tight end goes in motion left. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. This will be caught at about the 5. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post, because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
They come out here in the eye. They'll keep it on the ground. Campbell. And after the good gain last play, this time they say, uh-uh, as he's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage. Call it a loss of 2 on the play. And it'll be 2nd and goal. And again this time to the tailback. And he is in. Touchdown, New England. A great effort there. Taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Pats able to cash in for 6.
And that touchdown gives them a touchdown lead before they attempt the extra point. What a great way to end the half.
Yeah, great job to put themselves in front. And now see on the sideline, special teams defense scrambling, saying we want to preserve this for the final moments of this 2nd quarter. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Bengals getting set to go. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the 2nd half.
Rush coming, and he's taken down. Now before the 2nd down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout, as the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds to go in the 1st half. To throw on 2nd down to Stafford. One incomplete. He was looking for Gronk that time, and it's 3rd down.
But one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the 1st half. They've come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. Forced out to his left. Now he'll turn and throw deep back to the other side of the field. That'll be incomplete as the clock will stop with 14 seconds remaining.
Sure, that pass was incomplete as they made an attempt to get a big one downfield. But that's okay, because the 2nd part of that is, if you don't get the completion, at least you've told the defense you're trying to stretch them out a little bit, and they may have to change accordingly.
And he'll take it just outside the 40. Call it an even 40-yard punt, 7-0 on the return. And there'll be time for maybe one final play before halftime. Throw now on the final play. Now they go screen. It's complete. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. Sorry, Larry. Your hard work appreciated by so many men and women, but not today, as we get back to the action in the 2nd half. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. This is taken at the 3. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. The Bengal offense now with a football first here to begin quarter number three.
These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's going crazy on that sideline because that drives you berserk to come off the field, not really move the ball well. As you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even put points on the board. They've got to just take a deep breath, relax, try and figure out what is working, and call more of that.
Second down, here's Stafford. The Pats are going to get there. Down he goes.
The game plan for any defense is finding ways to make a quarterback uncomfortable in the pocket. When you bring pressure from all angles, you never know who's going to get home. In this case, the left cornerback, right in the face of him, puts him down.
Play action, Stafford. Escaping the pressure right. Looking downfield for Jones. And a shot taken on third down, unsuccessful. Fourth down now.
Well, we're into the second half now, and this is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know. The rhythm seems off.
Here's John Ryan now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. Good blocking there. Nearly sprung him. As it is, it'll go as a 19-yard return. And the Patriots will have great starting position as they take over first and 10. And they'll start this drive with very good field position. On first down, Campbell fighting his way down to about the 35-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there, it'll be second down.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
They'll keep it on the ground. Campbell, and a short gain down to about the 33. They'll get a couple yards on that one, and that's going to lead to a third down.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things. But the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
They're going to look to throw to the right side, and he's got Edelman. The completion there winds up a wash, and it'll bring up fourth down. The defense loves to hang their hat on that, don't they? You get a guy that catches the ball, but you stop him for no gain.
Without a doubt, because they're also used to trying to catch people after the catch, and they miss. And that turns into what? A huge play. We've seen it so many times. In this case, though, catch was made, put down right on the spot.
Here is the punter, Jones, as he gets this one away. This one angles out of bounds at a good spot in the coffin corner. And they're going to mark this out of the 5-yard line. Now the Cincinnati offense ready to see what they can do here.
Well, they're going to have to go at least 50, 60 yards here if they want to ensure that they don't have to punt the ball like they did last time.
Yeah, so what you're saying is we're not playing to just get out of the shadow of your own goal line, right? You're playing to make sure the punter doesn't see the field again. So it's not picking up a couple of first downs. You want to pick up 5 or 6 first downs and make sure you move the ball into their territory.
And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, and that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
They'll set up the screen for Freeman. And they'll mark him down right around the 9, just shy of the 10. A gain of 4 on the play, and it'll be third down. Still in search of the first down after that last completion.
Hey,
to throw on third down. Stafford, a bullet throw, but incomplete.
But the fans should be applauding this defense right now. It's an excellent job. They force a three and out, and they should be able to set up their guys with great field position, probably near midfield or better.
.44 on his first punt, and this is a good kick as well. Taking a couple yards shy of midfield. 12 yards on the return that time. And this offense, they're going to have excellent field position. They take over with a first and 10 on the short side of the field. Really nice starting field position here for the offensive unit. They'll try and start this drive in the air. Throw left side complete to Ingram. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. It'll be a Patriot first down on a pickup. Back now in Foxborough. We get set for the fourth quarter. Patriots have the lead. They also have the football. They'll run on first down. Campbell, he's to the 10. And he's in. Touchdown, Patriots. A great play there. His second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Patriots add 6 to their lead. And he certainly played a pivotal role with those two TDs and why they're up on the scoreboard right now.
Well, someone's all about winning, aren't they? Because he's not worried about the number. Sure, it's great to have 2 touchdowns. But the bottom line is what he's doing is contributing to their lead. He wants to continue to do so.
This fielded at the 2. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Cincinnati now ready to take the field.
And right now these guys, they're shuffling a little bit, maybe doubting, because 3 straight drives have ended with them punting the football away.
Yeah, so you start pointing fingers at each other a little bit, asking a lot of questions. What are you seeing? What are you getting? Maybe trying to narrow down your playbook a little bit and maybe get simpler rather than more complex in order to try and fashion together a drive.
He was trying to find Marvin Jones that time, and that'll bring up second down.
Well, they're slinging it, and then there's one you got to put a timer on, huh? I mean, that one came in hot.
Yeah, came in hot, but overthrown, out of his reach and incomplete.
They'll fake the give. Now Stafford. And he goes down. It's a Patriots sack. Vic Beasley, the outside linebacker, drops him for a loss of 6. They'll fake it. Now Stafford. This is Johnson. He's got it. A big 30-yard play on third.
You cannot write these guys off just yet. Not with a quarterback like that under center.
You mean it actually crossed your mind with him running the team that you could actually maybe write this game off?
Not yet.
Not a chance. Not with him. We've seen it too many times.
And he's brought down. Back-to-back nice plays. 12 yards that time and a first down.
Yeah, they really needed to get something going, didn't they? They had punted on the last 2 possessions. The running game starting to come to the front for them, providing a nice pickup there to keep this drive going.
On first and 10, Stafford. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
That's very well timed there defensively, because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right.
On second and 10, Stafford. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
It's a lot of contact going on there, and in the end, unable to keep 2 hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish.
This offense was on the move. Now 2 straight incompletions. And 10. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage looked defensively. Now a play fake it at Stafford. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Vic Beasley in there to get him his 2nd sack now of the afternoon.
Brandon, I think you understand the type of afternoon this offensive line is having. It is a long one for them. Long for you to spend it with me. Long for them trying to block those guys. They've given up a whole lot of sacks, and the speed and quickness that defensive line is eating them alive.
Well, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. Vic Beasley able to disrupt yet another pass play, his third sack of the afternoon. On first down, Campbell. And he will make his way back to where he started from, and that's all, as we will make our way to the two-minute warning. Time for a break. We're back to finish this one off after this. On second down now, Campbell finds a seam inside the 40. There he goes, right side. And all the way in. Touchdown, New England. A big play there. 51 yards. And the Patriots add on to their lead. He keeps carrying the ball into the end zone, and in this one, he's sort of carrying the team on his back.
He's the reason that they lead right now, no question about it. And you talk about on his back, he's not minding the extra weight at all, is he? Carrying that just as lightly as he does the football. Yeah, what a great performance so far.
Those three touchdowns, it's got him in the lead. This is fielded at the chalk of the 10. And he's going to be taken down shy of the 10 at the 9-yard line.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
Very tough spot here for the offense to start. On first down, Stafford here. Now a desperation throw deep downfield, and it drops down incomplete. Thought he might have had it. Instead, second down. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Now the Bengals on third down. They've had their troubles, just 1 for 6. This is third and 10. Off of play action, here's Stafford. They find some open field here. And he's going to get the first down as they bring him down at the 23. They'll get 14 on that one. Good for a Bengal first down. They go play action here on first down. He's going to let it fly. Looking for Jones, and it's intercepted. Picked off, Byron Jones. Takes this one back into the end zone to the Patriots.